Are y'all ready, kids?
Hello, everyone, and welcome back to TMM. And today we're going to be playing a game called Faster Than a Speed of Light. No, I'm sorry, Slower Than a Speed of Light. Sorry, I'm used to the FTL introduction. First off, I just want to say before we get into this game, there's obviously a warning screen for a reason. This game is very bright and colorful, fast-paced moving. If you have a history of epilepsy, please try not to watch this, this Let's Play. I just want to get that out there before we even continue. So I don't have people knocking on my door and saying they had a seizure because my video was so awesome. But anyway, let's get into the game. I want to say that I was given to this game through a link of a friend. And if you guys want to play this game for yourselves, sorry, the volume's really loud. But yeah, if you guys want to play this game, I will leave you guys a link in the description. This game is free. Play it, you know, support the developers. Even though it's free, just give them your feedback on them if you can. Because indie games are just awesome in the right hands. There's a lot of awesome indie games out there that I recommend. Some of them are free. Some good ones are free, but a lot of them good, so you have to pay for, but they're well worth the money. I can just name off a couple off my head. There's Limbo, there's Minecraft, there's FTL, there's Lone Survivor. I mean, the list goes on. And the games are really, really good, so I recommend you guys check this game out. But yeah, let's just get right into the game then. I just want to say that I kind of get an eerie vibe from this game, my first impressions, and I haven't even entered the game really. It's kind of like just an odd feeling, but I guess I'll read the introduction of the game. Once upon a time, in a quiet village, there was a little child. Sadly, the little child fell into a death's icy grip far too soon. The little child's spirit began the journey to become one with light. But the speed of light was too fast for the small and clumsy little spirit. Luckily, the spirit world is full of magical orbs that slow down light. Collect orbs to slow down light to walking speed, so you can finally move on into the afterlife. That wasn't there, but I just added it. So this is obviously a HUD of how many orbs you've collected out of 100, and this is the speed compared to this stuff right here. As light gets slower, you will start to see beyond what humans can typically see. Well, that's just fucking trippy as hell. Okay, here we go. This is the controls. Very simple, standard controls. Here we go. This kind of looks like the person from Journey, if you guys are familiar with that game. It's another... I don't know if it was an indie game developer, but... it's a worth game checking through. If you guys own a PlayStation 3. I remember it being like $15. I don't know. Check it out. It looks like a penguin mixed with the main character from that. But anyway, here's the game. Okay, so we are in the visible light spectrum. So I don't want to move too fast or I'll just start seeing some random ass shit. Okay. Probably look like a straight up new planes game. So yep, you can't jump, all you do is really just move. And you collect these orbs apparently, so let's just get started. So each orb you collect, the faster you go. I mean, that's what I'm getting from this. Oh, wow. So you don't want to keep pressing on. I don't think you should be really pressing on the W button. Oh, what are these guys doing here? You guys are like Chinese monks or something. Ugh, these huts look like they're from Africa. Whoa. I really don't know how to describe this game right now. Hopefully, like they don't jump out and try to like feed me to their gods or something. Probably a volcano somewhere near here. Oh, I wonder if I can go in there. Whoa, what the shit? I think I'm seeing colors I've never seen before. I'm not even joking. Whoa. I guarantee you if someone played this while they're on acid, they would have an epilepsy seizure. Epilepsy. Whoa. Dude, whoa. Never play this game when you're on drugs. I'm just gonna say that. Oh, I can't even. So I'm going into ultraviolet and infrared state right now, and I've collected over 50 orbs. So hopefully we can get through this level. Oh, this is just really trippy. I don't know how to really explain this. This is really, oh, I can't get it. There we go. Yeah, I really recommend this game if you just want something original. And alright, so you go faster when you go straight and not left or right. I'm trying to have to like drag, do a little drag race into these orbs. Sorry if my frame rate's a little low. Fraps isn't really the best to capturing frame rates. I think we're running at a constant 30 frames, so that's console quality. Even though consoles aren't really that. They're okay. I don't really want to get into that in war. They're just not my cup of tea. They used to be. Not anymore. So we're now at 62 orbs collected. And these guys are starting to look weird. And this is really weird. This actually reminds me of an old game I used to have on the PlayStation 1. I forget the name of it, but it was like a teddy bear, and like, I don't even really know how to describe it. I'll probably just confuse myself trying to describe it, just like this game. This game's undescribable. Just a bunch of random colors, I guess. I'm gonna try to do a whole recording of this game without... not necessarily quitting, just... okay. I'm trying to gonna do a whole level let's play. Oh wow, I can't keep on a straight path. This is really weird. Oh wow. Wow. If I had a webcam, I would totally show you... oh, what the hell? I would totally show you guys my face, because it looks like I'm just tripping some of the balls. Alright, so I'm up to 76 now. Alright, so let's try to turn around if we can. So I guess the more orbs you collect, the faster you go into the speed of light, and I'm not really sure if I want to go the speed of light. Oh wow, we are at full color. Hopefully I don't have like a history of epilepsy and I forgot and I repressed the memory and now I'm gonna have a seizure in my basement and no one's gonna help me. Alright, so we're up to 81, we only have 19 more to go. These really are starting to look like eyeballs now. This reminds me of a bad episode of Ed, Edd n Eddy. Don't even ask me why. I think those are mushrooms. Not really sure. Up to 84 now. Where are all the balls at? AKA orbs. Oh, wow. This game's really hard to focus on. It's just so weird. Alright, 86. 14 more to go. Alright, so I think the rest of them are over here. Hopefully I'm not wrong. Nope, yep, here are some right here. All my beautiful orbs. I don't really know how many levels are to this game, but it doesn't even matter because I'm going to beat this one right now. Oh, wow. I feel really bad because all I can say is wow during this commentary. Alright, 10 more. Yeah, definitely check this game out. It's very original in its own right. Besides its first person, but, you know, this game definitely worth checking out. Whether how good my advice is on checking out games, check it out. Holy shit. Four more, baby. One and boom. No, I haven't got it yet. Alright, get it right there, right there. Come on, you got it. Come on. This character's like drunk. He can't get one little orb. Alright, come on, come on, come on. There we go. We did it. All orbs collected in 7 minutes. Oh, wow. So this is what the game started off looking like before I was done. And I'm going speed of light now, baby. And, I don't really know what's going on now, to be completely honest with you. Oh, things are getting fucking weird. Whoa. I am in a fence right now, and I don't think I should be in a fence right now. Yeah, guys, I guess that's where I'm going to end it off. I warped outside the map, and I can't get out, so I'll catch you guys later. And thank you guys so much for watching. Peace off.